All right, everyone. So we were discussing the bank reconciliation statement accounts, and
yes.
we have almost completed this chapter. We will be doing one or two more questions in this chapter, and then we will finish this. And let's see if the time allows, then we will start a chapter, or we will discuss few multiple choice questions based on bank reconciliation statement. So if you have any doubt regarding the topics that we have discussed till now, you can ask those. Otherwise, we will start with the question. So Sameeksha or Halima, anyone else, if there is any doubt, you can ask.
Hi there. No, sir. Okay.
All right, so let's start with few more questions. So have I given you a few question as homework? Is there any question I gave you as homework in the last session, Sameeksha?
No, sir, it's fine.
Okay. So from the so this is the question that we will be discussing in today's class. From the following particulars, find out the correct bank balances as per cash book, and thereafter prepare a bank reconciliation statement as on 31st March 2019 of a sole proprietor. We have following information given. We have 9 entries, and based on these information, we have to prepare the bank reconciliation statement. This time, bank overdraft as per cash book is given. That means we need to find out the balance as per passbook. Okay, so start preparing the bank reconciliation statement, everyone. And along with you, I will also be preparing the bank reconciliation statement. And if you have any difficulty in posting any of the transaction in the bank reconciliation statement, do let me know. So first of all, we will basically prepare the format of bank reconciliation statement. Bank reconciliation statement. All right. So the first information that is given in the question is bank overdraft as per cash book is given. So balance as per cash book is overdraft. Balance as per cash book is given in overdraft. That means 80,000 minus. Okay. And after this, the second information is check deposited as per the bank statement but not entered in the cash book. So tell me, Halima, what will be the treatment of this transaction? Halima, what will be the treatment for this transaction?
We'll minus this.
We will minus this. Okay. Why we will minus this?
Because it's overdraft.
I'm not talking about overdraft. I'm talking about the second transaction. Check deposited and as per the bank statement, but not entered in the cash book. So we need to find out the balance of the passbook. All right. So whatever the bank has done, we have to do that.
So we have to add. Okay.
Yeah, correct. So bank, what the bank has done? Bank basically added the amount of check 3,000 into the bank. Basically our account has been credited by 3,000. So bank has already added 3,000. The cashier has not added this in the cash book. So tell me what we will have to do now. We will have to add this. No, we will have to add this 3000 will be added. Whatever the bank has done, we have to do that, because we need to find out the balance as per passbook. So whatever the bank has done, we have to do that. So 3000 is added by the bank, therefore we will also add 3000. Check deposited 3000. All right, is this clear, Samiksha, Halima?
Yes.
Okay. Third transaction, check recorded for collection but not sent to the bank. Check recorded for collection but not sent to the bank.
We have to minus.
Yes. See, in the bank statement, banker has not recorded this. Banker has not recorded 10,000. Bank has not recorded 10,000 because they haven't recorded it. So we also don't record this. But we have already added this into the bank, into the cash column, into the cash book. Therefore, we will have to reduce this, right? Because yes, bank has not added this. Therefore, we will also not add this. Therefore, and if we have already added this, we'll have to reduce this. So we will have to reduce the balance by 10,000. Check recorded for collection. Check recorded for collection. 10,000 under the minus column. Then credit side of bank column casted short. Credit side of the bank column casted short. What is the meaning of this? Credit side of the bank column casted short. That means cash book record the expense by 100 less. They have recorded expenses by less expenses by 1000. Casted less by 1000. That means we have to record, let's say, for example, if the expenses were of 12,000, we have only recorded it by 11,000. So that means we have recorded the expense by 1,000 less. So because we have recorded it by 1,000 less, so we will have to reduce further 1,000 in the cash book, right? Is that okay? In the bank statement, it must have been recorded at 12,000. It must have been recorded at 12,000, but the banker has recorded it only by 11,000. That means we have to further reduce the bank balance cash book by 1,000. So bank balance or cash book undercast. Cash book undercast basically mean you have not recorded the expense at the full value. 1000, this should be reduced. Okay. Now the fifth transaction, bank charges recorded twice in the cash book. Bank charges recorded twice in the cash book. Tell me how many times it should be recorded. It should be recorded only once.
Only once.
So bank has recorded only once. It has reduced only once. But you have reduced only, but you have reduced two times, 100 and again 100. So you have correctly entered the transaction once, but for the second time, you should not enter this because you have entered this value and bank has not entered this value. Therefore, you will have to add this back, right? Bank has only debited the account by 100, but you have credited the cash book by 200. Therefore, you have credited the cash book by 100 extra. Therefore, you will have to add this back. Bank charges will be added back and it will be written under the plus column. Samiksha, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Halima, is it okay?
Yes.
Okay. Now, the sixth transaction. Customer check returned as per bank. customer check returned as per bank. Customer, basically we have received a check from customer, and let's say we have deposited that check in the bank, and bank has returned the check. But that basically means bank has reduced the bank balance by 4,000, right?
So we have to reduce in cash.
We have to reduce this in cash book because we already have recorded this in the cash book. So we must have, because we must have recorded this. Just a minute. Check returned. So check returned. Customer have given us, and when he gave us, we have added this in the bank, in the cash book. But now it is not honored by the bank. It is returned by the bank. Therefore, we will have to reduce the cash balance. That is 4,000 will be written in the minus column. Okay, Halima, is this clear?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Okay. Now the seventh transaction, check issued but not dishonored on technical grounds. Check issued but not dishonored on technical grounds. That basically means we have given a check to someone, and when we gave the check, we have reduced the cash balance by 3,000. But later it is found that the check is dishonored by the bank. That means bank does not allow the payment against the check. That basically means the bank balance is not reduced, but you have reduced the cash balance. Now what you'll have to do, you will have to add this back, right?
Add it.
Yes.
So check issued but dishonored. Check dishonored. 3,000 will be added. Okay. Eighth transaction, bill collected by bank directly. So bank have added this into your bank account, into your bank balance 20,000, but the accountant is not aware about this. So as the bank has added this value 20,000 in your bank account, therefore the cash balance, cash book will also record this now. So 20,000 will be added. 20,000 in the plus column. Check received directly. Okay. Now, the last transaction, check received entered twice in the cash book. It should be recorded only once, but we have recorded this twice. That means the first time that we have recorded, it is correct. But second time that we have recorded, it is basically creating the difference between the passbook and the cash book. So we will be reducing the 5,000 now. So this 5,000 will be entered in the minus column. Check received 5,000 in the minus column. Right, Samiksha?
Yes.
Halima?
Yes.
Okay. So the finally, we can calculate the balance as per passbook. So balance as per
1,900.
Just a minute. Balance as per passbook. I'll have to check this. Just a minute. What is the solution of this question? I think I don't have the solution of this question. Okay, no problem. So how much the balance you have got, Tamiksha?
So 74,500.
So I guess this is the 74,900, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is, I guess, if you have calculated this correctly, so this will be the correct answer, 74,900. Okay. Is there any doubt, anyone?
No, sir.
No.
All right. So, I'm giving you one more question. Okay, so do this question. This is similar to the question that we have done just now. This time also bank overdraft is given, but this time the bank overdraft is given as per passbook. All right, so I'm giving you 10 minutes to solve this question. And I hope 10 minutes is more than enough. Halima and Samiksha, please try to solve this. And meanwhile, let me find some questions for you. Done, Samiksha?
Sir, almost, just 1 minute.
Halima, done?
Doing.
Is there any doubt, Halima? You are having problem in any item?
I'm doing it now.
So balance as per passbook is given this time, and that to an overdraft. So this will be written in the minus column.
Yes.
balance as per passbook minus 33,000. Check issued but not presented for payment. Check issued but not presented for payment. That means that it is recorded in the cash book, but it is not recorded in the passbook. So we need to find out the balance as per cash book, right? So we have to do whatever the accountant has done. So if it is presented for, just a minute, check issued but not presented for payment, right? Check issued but not, that means accountant has already recorded this. Accountant yes. has recorded this transaction and he must have reduced the cash balance by 17,500. And because the accountant has done that, so the banker will have to do this now.
Yes.
Right? So we will be reducing 17,500 as well.
Yes.
So we will write 17,500 in the minus column.
Minus column.
Then check deposited but not collected. Check deposited but not collected. That means check is deposited by the accountant. And when he have deposited the check, he must have added increased the cash balance by 21,000. But the banker has not recorded this, right? But because the accountant has already done this, therefore the banker will also have to do this. So 21,000 will be added, right, Samiksha?
Yes, sir. Add.
So 21,000 will be added in the bank column. Sorry, the plus column. Next, the check recorded in the cash book but not sent to the bank for collection. Check is recorded in the cash book, 4,000.
Yes, sir.
Accountant has already recorded this, but this is not sent by the business to the bank for the collection. But because the accountant has done this, accountant has added this, therefore the banker will also have to add this. So we will be adding 4,000 in the
yes.
plus column, positive column. All right.
Yes.
Next. Payment received from customer directly by the bank. Payment received from customer directly.
Pay minus.
Yes. So payment the customer have directly paid 7,000 in the bank. So the accountant has not recorded this. No, 7,000 is not recorded by the accountant. Bank has only recorded this. But because the accountant has not recorded this, therefore bank should also not record this. Therefore, we will be reducing 7,000, right? So this yes. 7,000 will be now written under the minus column. All yes. right. So we will do as the accountant has done. Okay. Now, sixth transaction, bank charges debited in the passbook. So bank charges has been debited by the passbook. That is, banker has debited 40 rupees. 40 has been debited by the banker. But the accountant has not recorded this transaction, right?
Yes,
he have reduced the bank balance, but the accountant has not reduced because he is unaware about that. So because he haven't reduced this, therefore we should not also reduce in the passbook. So what we will do now, we will add this.
Add it back.
40 will be added. So 40 will be written in the positive column. Then premium of life insurance policy of Mr. DH paid by the bank on standing instruction. So insurance premium paid by bank, that means yes. bank balance is reduced by 360 by the banker.
Yes.
But this 360 is not recorded anywhere by the accountant. Because the accountant has not recorded this, therefore we will also not reduce this. We will have to add this back.
Yes, sir.
Right? Okay. So 360 will be written in the positive column. And finally, a bill of rupees 6,000 dishonored on 30th March 2019 and bank paid noting charges rupees 20. A bill for rupees 600 dishonored on 30th March. Tell me, a bill of rupees 6,000 dishonored basically means that 6,000 has been sent for the collection. Bill of 6,000 has been sent for the collection and accountant have already recorded it as recorded in the cash book. In the debit side, but it is later discovered that this has been dishonored. All right. So basically passbook has not recorded this. So because accountant has increased the cash balance by 6,000, therefore it should be added into the passbook as well. So 6,000 will be added. So 6,000 will be written in the positive column of the bank reconciliation statement. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then there is noting charges as well. Bank paid noting charges. Bank paid noting charges, that means bank has paid 60 rupees. That means 60 account balance of the business is reduced by 60, but the accountant of the business has not recorded this. So because the accountant has not recorded this, therefore the banker will also not record this. So 60 will be added back. All right.
Yes.
So Samisha, tell me the final balance as per passbook.
So it is 26,080.
26,080 it is. Yes. So this is correct. Halima, you got the answer? Overdraft as per cash book, 26,080. Halima, you got the answer?
Yes.
Okay. So there is one more question that we will do. This is the question, guys. This is similar to the question that we have just done. So also try this. And I'm sure that Halima will be able to do this time. Halima, this question is especially for you. So again, I'm allowing 10 minutes to solve this. And I hope this 10 minutes is enough to solve this question. Tell me, Halima, if it is done. Halima, still doing?
Doing, sir.
Do it fast, please.
Yes, sir, I got it.
Tell me the answer, Samiksha.
Sir, total is 28,750 and the balance as per cash book is 10,970.
10,970. Yes, that is correct.
And is the total 28,750?
Total is also correct. Total is 28,750. Yes, and sir. The overdraft as per cash book is 10,970.
Yes, sir.
Well done. Very good. Halima, I'm still waiting for your answer. Halima, having any problem in any item?
No.
You are solving, no? Because I'm very doubtful that you are even trying. You don't give me any answer. All right, let's move to the next question. Just tally the solution, tell your solution, tell the solution that you are doing with the solution. Please, Halima, this is solution. Take the screenshot of this solution and try to solve the question and correlate your answer with this. Okay, let's move to the next question. And just a minute. I think I'm out of question now. All right, so this is it in this chapter. We won't be discussing any more question in this chapter, but I will be discussing few multiple choice question with you. Just yes. A minute, let me show you the multiple choice questions. All right, so these are the multiple choice question. We have done the similar question in the last class as well. So let's talk about the first question. The main purpose of preparing the bank reconciliation. This time you can see the answer as well. But if you have any doubt regarding the answer, just tell me. So the question is, the main purpose of preparing the bank reconciliation statement is to know the bank balance, to know the balance of bank statement, to correct the cash book, or to identify the causes of difference between the cash book and the bank statement. So the answer is D. So is this clear, Samiksha?
Yes, it's clear.
Okay. Next question is, in cash book, bank charges recorded. In cash book, bank charges are recorded on which side? On the debit side or the credit side? It is recorded on the credit side because it is an expense, right?
Yes.
Bank charges leads to the reduction in the cash balance, or you can say the bank balance. So it is therefore recorded on the credit side of the cash book. Next, unrepresented check, also referred to as, see, unrepresented check which is not presented in the bank. It happens so that we sometime issue the check, but the party to whom we have issued the check is not does not present the check in the bank. So that is called unpresented check. Unpresented check are also referred as outstanding checks, right? Checks that is not presented in the bank is considered as the outstand. Just keep key or just remember these points, because I'll be sharing the test today, and probably the test will be, I guess it will be tomorrow, and question will be asked from these. So similar question will be asked in your test. All right.
Yes.
So when extract of cash book and passbook are given for common period, only dash item are considered for preparation of bank reconciliation statement. When extract of cash book and passbook are given for common period, only uncommon item are considered for the bank reconciliation statement. All right. You didn't get this. See, when for example, you have the information regarding the cash book and the passbook regarding March, for the month of March only. All right.
Yes, sir.
So in order to prepare the bank reconciliation statement, you need to find out the differences. No, what is the difference between the cash book and the passbook? So only uncommon items will be considered. Items
uncommon
that is not
as in the value.
Yeah, uncommon. Oh, that means which is not recorded in the cash book and it was not recorded in the passbook. So only if the item are common, that means any item which is recorded in both the books, that means for the purpose of bank reconciliation.
Yes.
Yeah, we do not need such items. All right. So bank reconciliation statement represent. What is a bank reconciliation represent? It is not a ledger. Yeah, it is not a ledger. It is not a journal. It is just a statement.
Yes.
And it is not any, you cannot say that it is a part of books of account. It is just for the purpose of internal control. Management prepared this, accountant prepared this for the purpose of internal control only. It is not the part of books of account. So therefore, it is not.
Can we call it as a financial statement also?
It is not a financial statement.
It's not a
statement. So therefore, that is what I'm saying, that it cannot be considered as the books of account.
Yes, sir.
Bank reconciliation statement is not a reconcile record, memorandum statement, ledger account, procedure to provide cash book adjustment. So all of these are correct except this. So it is not
journal or ledger.
Yeah, it cannot be ledger or journal. Next, bank reconciliation statement is a part of bank statement, memorandum statement, part of journal, ledger. So all of these are incorrect except the memorandum statement. It is a memorandum statement. Then a bank reconciliation statement is prepared to know the causes of difference between. Why it is prepared? Without looking at the answer, can you tell me why bank reconciliation statement is prepared?
Check the bank column of both the cash book and the passbook. If there's a difference, like suppose it's not recorded in one of them, so we'll see if it's
correct. So option B in the option are correct. Next is, when bank statement shows a debit balance, it means when bank statement shows a debit balance, that means we have the overdraft, right?
Yes.
That is an overdraft is unfavorable.
As per passbook, not cash.
Yes. So that is basically unfavorable balance.
Yes.
All right. Uncollected checks are also known as Uncollected checks basically means that we have deposited the check in the bank, but it is not collected by the bank. That means the balance it is not cleared, and you can say the amount is not yet credited into the account.
Yes.
So it is known as both. It is also called uncleared check, or it can also be called as outstation checks. So both of these are correct. All right. Okay. Favorable balance means what is the what is the meaning of favorable balance? What is favorable balance?
Credit balance as per passbook.
Credit balance as per first is credit balance in the cash book.
That is
unfavorable. That is overdraft. Credit balance in the bank statement.
Yes, sir.
Credit balance in the bank statement.
It is not overdraft, so it's favorable.
In the bank statement, it is not overdraft, right? So this is also this is favorable, right?
Favorable.
And debit balance in the cash book, this is also favorable.
This is also favorable. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, balance shown in the balance sheet is balance shown in the balance sheet. Which balance is shown in the balance sheet? Passbook balance, adjusted. You know the balance sheet, right? Balance sheet are you can say the it is in a statement where the assets and liability are shown. So in the balance sheet, which balance is shown? Cash book balance, passbook balance, adjusted cash balance, or none of these? So obviously cash balance will be shown there, because cash
is what about adjusted cash book? Like, is it BRS after adjustment?
Adjusted cash book is not BRS. See, didn't give you questions to correct the cash book. There are a few more questions in the bank reconciliation statement where we need to prepare a correct cash book by correcting the misadjustment or the incorrect entries that we have done earlier. We have to correct the cash book. And for that, the cash book that we prepare is called adjusted cash book. So cash book might contain, there is a possibility that there are certain mistake in the cash book. And for correcting those mistakes, we prepare the adjusted cash book. So balance shown in the balance shown as per the adjusted cash book is not shown in the balance sheet. Only the cash book balance is shown in the balance sheet. Okay, now cash book and the bank statement shows what? It shows the opposite of each other, right? Cash book, yes. And bank statement. All right, guys, so these are the question based on the bank reconciliation statement. I hope the test that I will prepare, you will be able to do the question. And if you feel any problem in this chapter, do let me know in the next class. So this is it for today's session. Probably we will start a new chapter tomorrow. Okay.
Okay.